Hey guys, Pedro here to tell you about the latest from Angelo Zapatrida, Aftermath, out October 20th on Century Media Records. The album has 10 tracks, 50 minutes in length, and this is the band's 8th full-length studio record. They are a Spanish thrash metal band. The design of this album allows you to feel like it has the best of two different worlds. On one hand, it's an album that has a lot of versatility. Every song pulls you in a different direction. Every song has its own path, its own mechanisms, its own fingerprint, if you will. But when you take a step back and you look at all of these songs together, they all have the same starting point, and that is the common ground between them. This allows the record to have versatility on one hand, but still feel very balanced on the other. As far as the sound is concerned, this is a record that doesn't fall that far away from what this band has done. So if you think about the fruit hanging from the tree, well, it stayed close to the tree once it hit the ground. It's an album that perhaps has a little bit more bite on the guitars, and the way the guitars are blended in with the drums feels a little bit smoother than perhaps the previous album. But as far as the riffage, as far as the overall sonic experience, this is the DNA of the band. Heavy, centric guitar sound where the riffage really takes control of how the songs move, the direction of the tracks, the nuances within the songs, the ebbs and flows that exist in songs, from song to song. All of that really starts and ends with how the guitars permeate their experience across all 10 tracks. Like I said, a very guitar-centric album. But the guitars are not just about the chugs. It's not just about having chugging riffing across all 10 songs. They have different elements, they have different textures. And those nuances of having different textures and different elements from track to track, or even within songs themselves, allow you to see the different movement that these tracks have. It allow you to see the different directions. And when you look back at what I said about each track having its own DNA, a lot of its own DNA and fingerprint really comes from the versatility of that guitar sound, not depending just on a chugging riff to really carry you forward, but rather infusing other elements that allow the sound to be a little bit more richer, more groovier at times. This is definitely a groovier sounding record. It still has all of its thrash metal elements in there, but it has a lot of groove mixed in or blended in with that more thrash, traditional thrash sound. It's almost an album that brings in moments of the past, definitely has moments of old school thrash metal, but it also has moments of more modern style approach, not just from a sonic point of view, but also from a vocal standpoint. Now, I mentioned the drums slightly in terms of how well they blended with the guitars, and that's something that I enjoyed a lot more, the drum sound, on this record than on the self-titled. This album had a little bit more oomph, not just on the guitars as far as the bite, but there's a little bit more oomph on the drums. They don't feel as stretched out. There's still songs, there's still moments where the sound of the drums becomes a little bit thin because of how the cymbals hit in the mix. But overall, the big picture of this record drum-wise is an album that has a lot more depth, that allows the tracks to have a little bit more of width as well. They're not as narrow. The guitars, while being powerful and being the driving force of the record, they're not overshadowing or not overpowering the impact that the drums can have in the overall sonic experience. I felt like from a mixture point of view, this album comes across a little bit more clear. Maybe because of the groove that this album has also allows them to have a different approach sound-wise in terms of how to put everything together. Because now you're not just concentrating on heavy guitars pushing you forward, you also have to think about the groovier sections of the songs and what are you gonna do with those. So having a much better approach in terms of how the drums complement the guitar sound on the heavier side, but also give it some room for the groovier side, it makes both of them feel a lot more stronger, a lot more powerful. Now, when it comes to the vocals, here's where I have perhaps my only pet peeve about the entire album. In my humble opinion, it has too many guest appearances. You have 10 songs, there's 4 guest appearances. That's almost, that's 40% of the record. I think that's a little bit too much. It dilutes the novelty of having a guest appearance. If you have too many, then it's not a novelty anymore. And I think the beauty of guest appearances is to be that novelty, to be that one or two track that has one or two guest appearances that you're not expecting, that really throw the listener for a loop. When you start to throw 4 in a 10 track album, you're taking a little bit away from that, and you're also taking a little bit away from your own DNA that you want to infuse the record with. Not to say that I didn't like the cameos. That's not what I'm saying here. The guest appearances all fit the bill in terms of what they added to those songs. Like the Jamie Jassa song was a great example of how it works really well. His voice works really well in that track because it's a track that, while having this thrash metal sound, it still has some hardcore elements. It also has some groove elements. So I liked these cameos. I like these features on this record. I just think they pushed the envelope a little bit too much. Maybe one too many. It could have been done in a different way. But that is my, like, this is me really nitpicking this album. That's my only pet peeve. Because outside of that, the vocal performance on this record is really top notch. Like, I love the versatility, the clean vocals, the more singing vocals, if you will, some of the backing vocals, some of not choirs, but like group singing, if you will, to give a live experience to some of these songs, some of the layers that they used, the different approach, the different texture in terms of how the vocals come across, in terms of how they interact with the tracks. I mean, this is a very live record from that standpoint. The vocals feel very organic. They work really well with these tracks, and they're so strong. Like I said, you almost don't need these many guest appearances because they just could easily carry the record on their own. And as versatile the sound is, and as much as this sound takes you on individual journeys on a track-by-track basis with its own fingerprint, with its own DNA, the exact same thing could be said about the vocal performance on this album. And overall, the beauty of this record is what I said earlier. This is an album that has the DNA of the band. It showcases their past, their present, but it also opens the door towards their future. This is not a band that's sitting still and resting on their laurels. This album has that old school thrash metal DNA through it, but that's not the only thing you're gonna get. There's a more modern approach to thrash metal starting to peek in, starting to have an impact on how this album comes across. The bridge between these two worlds and the groove influences that they squeezed in between those two worlds really allows this album to feel unique because of all that it offers and how it offers it. Outside of that little element that I nitpicked, this is one of the best thrash metal albums of the year. It's really gonna have a battle with perhaps Overkill, who in my humble opinion released one of the best thrash metals of 2023. This one is not that far off. The two are neck and neck because this is a really strong album across all 10 songs, across all 50 minutes. And these days it's hard to put a record with 10 tracks, 50 minutes in length, that doesn't really lose any steam as you progress down the line. As far as favorite songs are concerned, I want to start off with Scavenger. This is the opening track on the record, and it's a track that kind of sets the tone that this is going to be an album that's going to be off to the races. It's really about how fast. It's not about are you going to move fast, it's rather about how fast are you going to move, or how fast these tracks are going to move. And this one has great intensity, great aggression, moving really well, and I love the combination of drums and guitars working, cooperating with one another, really blending well in order to create this wall of sound that's just galloping towards the listener. The vocals, the delivery, the tonality match that same intensity of sound, match that same aggression within the sound. The chorus is super hooky on this track. I mean, this album has great choruses, really hooky choruses. This track is no different. And it connects really well, the song. It's not a track that has this huge break or that has this huge divide between verses and chorus. There's a nice flow as you go from one to the other, just changing in terms of how hooky that chorus is. The solo section is outstanding, but this album has incredible solos, most of them really explosive, breaking a little bit away from the DNA of the track, infusing a lot more energy into tracks that have already a ton of energy. There's a few solos on this album that kind of continue the same vibe as the track has. Those, perhaps because of that nature, don't have the same impact as the one on Scavenger has, because the one on Scavenger really feels over the top. It has a little bit of an old school aroma to it, completes the song. Next you have Rats. Fast, heavy, groovy. These are all things that you can, words that you can use to describe the way this song comes across. It's almost a mixture of old school Testament, Ritual era, with Pantera, Vulgar Display era, maybe a little bit of Cowboys from Hell. This track has that DNA. It's like old school thrash with old school groove, the two worlds coming together, creating a really nice textured song, then adding some backing vocals, not as a choir, but as like as group vocals. Really hard to define it, but it gives a live nuance to the song. It feels like this is a live track. It feels like, you know, they're performing it and the audience is singing back to them that specific line. I think that works really well. It makes the song not only feel live, but it feel very organic in the way that it comes across. The groovier pockets work really well with a more high tempo chugging sound that the rest of the song has, creating this really nice ebb and flow. A song that feels like it's going away, coming in, going away, coming in. Great movement all around, adding a sense of uniqueness to the overall experience. Great solo section once again, a high octane track with a high octane solo. Last but definitely not least, I Am Hatred. This is a Circle Pit song. If they play this song live, I would be surprised if a Circle Pit doesn't get going. It has all of those elements. It sounds great. It feels like you're listening to a live track recorded in the studio. It has that ability to make you headbang, but also make you want to move around. So it has that pit move feel to it. It really pushes the envelope musically and vocally. It takes it all the way to the edge of the band sound, at least the band sound on this record, without breaking that edge, without going over it and completely changing how it would match the other tracks, because it would be something completely different. So they pushed as far as they could go when it comes to intensity and aggression, chugginess, without going beyond it. The guitars and drums together drive the song. This is not a song that depends just on the guitars to be driven. This song is driven by both elements working really well as one. And then the vocals are super intense, super aggressive, matching the overall intensity of the track. Really explosive song all around. But when you have a track called I Am Hatred, you're not gonna have a ballad. So this song really represents the title, the lyrics, the experience. Definitely a track that these guys have to consider playing live, because it has all the right condiments, same as Rats, all the right condiments to be a great, great live song. This is it, Angelus Apatrida with Aftermath, out October 20th on Century Media. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.